Hey guys, it's Kim Dao here. Welcome back to my channel. As you can already guess from the title of this video, I am going to be trying on wedding dresses for the very first time. If you guys have been following this channel for, I guess, the past couple of months, you would have known that I just got engaged. So yes, I am going to be planning a wedding for next year. I don't have the exact date for the wedding yet because I'm waiting for venues to get back to me on their availabilities. But actually, I'm hoping to hear back by the end of this week. So hopefully by the end of this week I'll be able to confirm my venue and the date so I can finally start planning the wedding. On this channel, I love trying on different clothing from online websites, and I like to show you guys the picture that the website uses to advertise the product so you guys can see for yourself if what you see is actually what you get. Now for wedding dresses, like I said, I have not started looking for my wedding dress yet, but I do have kind of an idea on what I want.
Girl, I've been saving wedding photo inspirations for the past 2 years.
So I kind of have an idea of what dress I would like to wear on our wedding day. My dream wedding dress at the moment is probably a dress with long lacy sleeves. I kind of want it to be like a V-neck dress in a way, so it kind of go down like this, and then the rest of it is just lace. But then at the back, I kind of want the back to be open. Keeping that in mind, I picked out a few dresses on YesStar so I can pick bits and pieces of each dress that I like and then perhaps make my wedding dress later. I don't exactly know where or when I'm going to get my actual wedding dress, but for now, I'm going to try on the YesStyle dresses for you guys today, and hopefully you guys will enjoy it as well. Just before I start this video, as always, if you guys haven't yet, make sure you guys subscribe to my channel, click on that notification bell so you won't miss another video from me, and also follow me on my vlog channel because Vlogmas is here, and I am going to be posting every single day in December. I will be in Korea and in Japan for Vlogmas, so you guys will get a Korea or Japan vlog every single day. And also when I guess go around in Korea and Japan, I'll be picking up bits and pieces for my wedding as well. So make sure you guys subscribe to that to keep up to date with all my wedding plans. This is the first dress, and I decided to film in this place because you've got this big full-length mirror just behind me, so you guys can actually see what the dress looks like in full length, because it's a better representation on what the dress looks like in person rather than me just standing on a stool to show you guys the length. This dress was $213. I got this one in a flat white in a size extra small. This dress comes in two different kinds, one with the train and one without. I chose the one without the train, but I did pick some dresses with a train, so don't worry about that. Now, okay, compared to the photo, it looks exactly the same. Super flowy. You've got some lovely lace detailing on the skirt part of the dress, and you've got sequins sewn inside the dress as well, so it gives you that really sparkly look. Now, you've got a lot of layers, so let me just count them for you guys. The first layer is the one where the lace is stuck on, and actually, the lace is sewn onto the layer, which is good because if you guys watch my prom dress video, the problem with a lot of the dresses was that the lacy part was just glued onto the layer and it came off really easily. And of course, on your wedding day, you don't want your dress falling apart. Now, the second layer, it's like an organza, and you have sequins sewn inside. The sequins are sewn in a pattern as well that is really nice, and it gives your dress a really pretty glow when you move it around. The third layer is just one layer of organza with nothing on it. Another layer of organza. This is the fourth layer. Fifth layer is another organza layer. Then you've got this white opaque material. Sorry guys, I don't know much about material names, so I'll try my best to describe them. Okay, this is like hard organza, and the top layers are like softer organza. Then you've got a soft cotton like material with some organza sewn on at the bottom to give your dress that puffy look. Yeah, you've got a lot of layers on this dress. That's how you're able to get this princess like look. The lace flower patterns, I kind of wanted more smaller patterns, so it kind of looks like flowers are floating around your body. Once again, I've never tried on a dress like that before, so I don't know if it will actually look good, but that's my vision of my dream wedding dress. For the first wedding dress I tried on, I like it, guys. Like, it was only $213. I don't know about you guys, but I went to a few wedding shows after I got engaged, and I looked at a few different wedding dresses, They were so expensive. They were well over $1,000 per dress. So for $213, that's a really good deal for a dress. So yeah, if you guys want to have a wedding but are on a budget, then maybe this is something that you can consider, because yeah, pretty good deal for a good quality dress. This one here is a size extra small and I think it fits me perfectly. You can do it as tight or as loose as you want. The waist part actually fits me perfect as well. I think I'm going to keep this one for inspiration actually. All right, next dress. The hard part is taking it on and off. Wish me luck. Hopefully it doesn't take me half an hour. This is dress number two. It was $252 in a white in a size extra small. Now guys, honestly, first impressions, I don't like this dress at all. I was expecting this dress to be better than the first one I showed you guys because it was more expensive. Now comparing this to the photo, I don't think it looks the same, because in the photo, the top layer, it kind of sticks out a bit more and the material looks like it stays. On the dress that I have, it looks like they tried to make it look like the photo but kind of failed, because okay, the part that should be sticking out, they did use harder material, so you've got that effect, but it just doesn't look good, you know, because it's not exactly sticking out like what it looks like in the photo. Furthermore, the dress, the front layer, look at this, the lace part is falling off already. And is this glued? No, it's actually like sewn on, but it's falling off. So yeah, the quality, guys, it's itchy. It doesn't feel comfortable. It looks weird as well because, okay, this is my waist right here. So I put the dress on correctly. It's like, look at all this. Like, it doesn't sit well on my body. So it's not exactly flattering as well. It just looks a bit weird. Let me show you guys the layers of this dress. So first of all, front layer. So you've got the weird parts here that's a bit more harder, so it kind of sticks out. You've got lacy bits sewn onto them. Second layer is just a plain soft organza layer. Third layer, same one. Fourth layer, same thing. Fifth layer, which is kind of like a satiny material to give that bit of shine. Sixth layer, you've got kind of like a sheer material here that's really soft and comfortable. And then you've got the organza on top to give it that puffy effect. I just think the last one was so much better in quality, and I just can't believe this one was more expensive, because yeah, it's falling apart on me already, and it's not comfortable, it's itchy, doesn't fit well as well, because especially this part here looks very strange. So I think the maker of this dress didn't actually take their own photos. They just stole the photo and tried to replicate the dress and failed. So I guess this dress here is a perfect example of what you see is not what you get in person when shopping online. But yeah, that's my opinion on this one, so let's go to the next dress. This is the next dress. It was $211. I got this one in flat without the train in a size extra small in the color champagne. First impressions of this dress, guys, this is absolutely beautiful. I'm just really confused because the last dress was the most expensive one and it turned out to be the worst one. So I guess just because it's more expensive doesn't mean that it's going to be better. Now this dress came with a few extras. So I got this veil, which I just stuck into my ponytail, and then a pair of gloves as well. On my actual wedding day, I am not going to wear gloves because I'm just not really a fan of wearing gloves. Whenever I wear gloves, my fingers turn to butterfingers and I just drop everything that I hold. And also I don't really like the look of wearing gloves, so yeah. That's a no for me. Another extra part it came with, underneath the dress, I put this on myself just before I put the dress on. These circular things that you put underneath your dress to make it puffy. Now, yes, it does make the dress look a bit more princess-like, but I don't know, there are some parts that keep poking into my leg, so that kind of hurts a little bit. But comparing the dress to the photo, it looks exactly the same. In person, this dress is just stunning, guys. So you can tell the quality is really good as soon as you try it on. When I first tried on the previous dress, I knew straight away when I just touched it, this is just crap quality. But this one here, you can tell that it's really well made. So the first layer, this one here, is actually attached to this lacy part here. So you've got the sheer layer with some flowers cut out, and they are, yep, sewn onto the dress, so that's great, won't come off. The next layer is actually a lace, which is different to the other dresses I just showed you guys. Then you've got, this is a sheer shiny material. Then you've got an organza part. Then you have this thick white material. Underneath that, you have some organza. And then the last layer is just some silky material with some organza sewn on top to give it that princess look. Now this dress here is in the champagne color. So this sheer shiny part here is actually like a slight pink color, which makes it look really beautiful. So if you just look at the dress front on, it looks like it's white, but if you look closely, it's kind of pinkish white. The detailing on the front part of this dress as well is absolutely gorgeous. I just love what a lacy flower pass on it. So yeah, definitely going to take inspiration from this dress. I really like this part here and I like how it flows with the dress. It gives the dress more shape. It actually keeps its shape compared to that previous dress. I know I'm trashing that dress a lot. I just really hated it. Just telling you guys the truth on how I feel. This one here though, it's a bit more uncomfortable to wear. I find it a bit harder to walk around in, and that's because, well, it's these arm parts. You can't really move around that much. It kind of constricts you. As I move around, the dress is very flowy, so it's so cool. Sizing wise, I think it fits really well. I kind of tried to make the back part a bit more tight as well, so it just kind of fits me a bit better. So you can adjust it accordingly to how it would fit you. For the first dance, this dress would look so cool, especially if you're spinning around. So, you know what? I might even consider wearing multiple dresses in a day. Who knows, maybe I will actually wear this dress on my wedding day because I love it that much. This dress was $211. It's a bargain. The quality is amazing and I've seen dresses like this in store in Australia for well over $2,000. So I am just extremely happy with this dress and can highly recommend it to you guys. I'm going to take out that extra petticoat thing underneath to show you guys what it looks like without it. Without it, I mean, it still flows out quite a bit and looks nice, but when I spin around, it's not as, you know, flowy as it was with that on. So, maybe I might just keep that just in case for on my wedding day, because when I had the first dance, I want my dress to be nice and flowy. I can recommend this dress. Let's go on to the next one. This is the fourth dress and this one was $129. I got this one in a white in a size extra small. Now this one was the cheapest dress that I got on YesStyle. I did go through all of their wedding dresses and I didn't really want to go under $100 because I just felt that if I did, then perhaps the quality would be atrocious. But if you guys are interested, I might do a video where I go through all the cheaper dresses and perhaps I can try out some of the cheaper ones on YesStyle. So this dress is one of those short ones with a very long train. Comparing this to the photo, I don't really think it looks the same. And honestly, I did not expect this dress to be anything amazing. I kind of expected it not to be that great quality. Looking at the photo, the dress looks really nice, but in person, it's just very cheap looking. Honestly, it kind of looks like a dress that you wear to a party where you're dressing up as a bride, or perhaps even a hen's night. Like, actually, for a hen's night, I would not mind wearing this dress. This would be perfect for that, because obviously on that night, that's the night you go out and party, and I would not want to go out and party in an expensive dress. So this one, you know, it kind of suits the occasion for that, but definitely on your wedding day, I don't think this dress looks great at all for that. This dress here, the material, I don't know, it just doesn't stay properly. The shape is a bit weird as well. The train doesn't look very nice either. But once again, like I said, if you want to dress up as a bride, or if you want to wear a mock wedding dress for your hen's night or was a bridal shower, then this would be perfect for that. So I think I'm actually going to keep this dress just in case I want to wear it for the bridal shower or the hen's night. Arm part as well, it keeps on moving up, so it doesn't even stay properly. It's actually surprisingly really comfortable, despite my arm bit going up a lot. I mean, I can move around very easily in the dress, even with the long train. If you are seriously looking for an actual wedding dress, then I don't recommend this one. But if you want something for fun, then yeah, this one's perfect. This is the fifth and last dress. It was $371. I got this one in the long train in a size extra small. Now guys, first impressions of this dress. Oh, I love it so much. It's so amazing. Comparing it to the photo, this one looks exactly the same. Now, I wanted to try out a range of different dresses. So I did want to try out some cheaper dresses, but also slightly more expensive ones. Now, even though this one was 371, guys, if I bought this dress in Australia, this would have cost a lot more than $371. The quality of this dress feels really amazing. It's actually really comfortable to wear as well, despite how heavy it is because of the long train. The material feels really nice as well and not itchy at all. Let's go into detail with this dress. So first off, the layers of this dress. You've got the sheer layer, and then you've got some flower bits that are embroidered, but they're not embroidered onto the actual material itself. It's actually just stuck on. They are actually sewn on, so that's great. So this one is just kind of like a white checkered pattern, and if you look really closely, you've got some sequins to give you that shine as well. Next layer after that, you've got the thick white material. Then you have the soft material with the organza on top, and you actually have two layers of organza to make the dress kind of puff out a bit more. Walking around with this dress, despite it being so heavy, it's actually really easy because the material they used is really comfortable. I'm kind of stepping on the dress right now, but that's because I'm not wearing any shoes. If I do, then it would be a bit more easier to walk around with. Sizing wise, the dress fits fine. It's just this part here keeps falling down, but that's not really an issue at all. Maybe I can just get it altered where I can pull the strap down a bit to make it stay. You can tighten or loosen the lace at the back, which is really handy. I made this one a little bit more loose as well, so it would be a bit more comfortable for me to wear. Also came with this veil, and this one is a lot longer than the other veil. So yeah, this one pretty much goes to the ground. Not sure if I want a veil that long. Haven't really thought that far yet. If you look closely, you can tell it's really well made. There's a corset here. They've got some beautiful detailing with flowers, sequins, and all that stuff on there. Oh, it's just so beautiful. But some of the dresses I wore were just so beautiful that I think I am going to keep them and perhaps wear them for photo shoots, or perhaps even wear them as a second dress on the day. I've been to a few weddings before where the bride has worn two or three different dresses. So yeah, something that I can keep in mind. Overall, I am just in love with this dress. It's so beautiful. And yeah, if you guys get this dress, then it's definitely worth the money. Now, I got the long train version, which is more expensive than just the floor length one. I believe if you want the train, you have to spend another $50, which is really up to you. Some people like the train, some people don't. I don't know if I want a train on my dress or not yet, but I think maybe I might have a long veil instead of a train, just because I feel like a train would just make the day a bit more harder to walk around with. You always need someone to hold it for you, and especially at night time when you're having the reception, it's just going to be a pain in the butt. So yeah, I will think about it. Anyway, that's the end of this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys want me to try out more wedding dresses on different websites, let me know in the comment box down below and I will check them out ASAP. Thumbs up this video if you enjoyed it, and also subscribe to this channel if you haven't yet. Turn on that notification bell so you won't miss another video from me. And also follow me on all of my social media as well if you guys want to keep in touch with what I get up to. Follow me on my vlog channel for Japan and Korea vlogs. Also some wedding preparation vlogs as well. I'll try my best to do them. If you guys want to find the links to the dresses, I will link everything in the description box down below, so make sure you guys check that out. Thank you so much guys for watching. I love you all, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye guys!